and welcome to Bite Size Med. In this video, we're going to look at some of the different types of epithelial tissue. First, let's look at the levels of organization. There are cells, cells form tissues, and tissues together form organs. There are different kinds of tissues in the human body. There's epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and nervous tissue. Epithelial tissue is what lines the surface of the body, and also the insides of cavities and vessels. Epithelial cells are what form epithelial tissue, and they can be classified based on two things. One, what do they look like? What are they shaped like? Two, how many layers do they have? What shapes can they have? Squamous, cuboidal, and columnar. Squamous cells are thin and flat cells. From the surface, they appear like a sheet of flat polygonal cells. Cuboidal cells are like cubes. They are as tall as they are wide. Columnar cells are taller, so the height is more than the width. These cells, they have an apical portion and a basal portion. The base is towards the underlying tissue and it rests on a basal lamina. Below the basal lamina is a reticular lamina, and that's from connective tissue. So this whole thing forms the basement membrane. Epithelial cells, they sit on a basement membrane. In cuboidal cells, the nucleus is at the center of the cell. In columnar cells, the nucleus is towards the base of the cell. Now, if these cells are arranged in a single layer, it's called simple epithelium, simple squamous, simple cuboidal, and simple columnar. If it's more than one layer, it's called stratified epithelium. Stratified squamous is the most common. Stratified cuboidal and columnar are rare. Now, sometimes, particularly with columnar epithelium, the cells can be arranged such that they appear like multiple layers, but they're actually just one layer. It's falsely stratified, that pseudo-stratified epithelium, because it just looks like it's stratified. All of the cells touch the basement membrane, but some of them don't reach the surface. First, let's pick up simple epithelia, simple squamous epithelium. It's a single layer of thin, flat squamous cells. How would that be useful? To quickly exchange substances like gases. Where does gas exchange happen? Alveoli. So that's one example of simple squamous epithelium. Now the lining of blood vessels, it also has simple squamous epithelium, but it's called endothelium. The lining of blood vessels and lymphatic vessels is called endothelium. While the lining of serous membranes, again it's simple squamous, and it's called mesothelium. Let's take a little detour here. There are three germ layers, the ectoderm, endoderm, and the mesoderm, and they give rise to all the tissues of the body. Now, which would you think epithelia are derived from? All of them. So the skin epithelia and the epithelia in some parts of the mouth, those are examples of epithelia derived from the ectoderm. While the epithelia that lines the respiratory tree and most of the gastrointestinal tract, they are from the endoderm. The endothelium in blood vessels and the mesothelium, they are mesodermal. So the mesothelium is mesodermal in origin and lines the serous membranes, like the pleural, the pericardial, and the peritoneal cavities. And that, like I said, is simple squamous epithelium. Simple cuboidal epithelium is just a layer of cuboidal cells with the nucleus in the center, and they line ducts of glands. They are active, so they can secrete and absorb. So they can also line the renal tubules, like the proximal convoluted tubule. This can additionally have microvilli on the apical surface, and that forms a brush border. This brush border, it increases the surface area for absorption, which makes sense because the PCT is the main site of reabsorption in the nephron. Simple columnar cells also secrete and absorb just like simple cuboidal cells, but they are taller and the nucleus is towards the base. Now, one of the things we saw that the apical surface can have is microvilli. Another thing is cilia. So if the cells don't have cilia, then they're just simple columnar epithelium, and that lines some parts of the digestive tract like the stomach and the small intestine. But ciliated columnar cells, they have those cilia on the apical surface. And these cilia, what do? They can move things along the passage. So they line structures like the fallopian tubes to move the ova towards the uterus. Now I said columnar cells, they can perform the function of secretion as well. So in some linings, like in the digestive tract, they can be modified cells like goblet cells, which secrete mucin. Now let's move on to stratified epithelium. Now remember I said stratified squamous epithelium is the most common, and it could be keratinized or non-keratinized. The thing about stratified epithelium is that as you move towards the surface, the cells get flatter. So the basal cells are more cuboidal, then they become polygonal, and the topmost cells, they are flat. Non-keratinized epithelium obviously doesn't have keratin, and the topmost cells, they have nuclei, they are alive. They line moist surfaces, so examples for this would be some parts of the mouth and the esophagus, and even the corneas. In keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, the layer on top is dead cells with no nuclei, and they have keratin. So this is how skin is. Skin is keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. What does this kind of epithelium do? It's protective. So you just have to think of the skin. The cells, they keep getting replaced. So there's a lot of mitosis that happens here. Now we saw that the cells are getting flatter as we move towards the surface. But there's another type of epithelium where that doesn't happen, and that is called transitional epithelium. And it's what lines the bladder, so it's also called urothelium. Its appearance changes depending upon whether the bladder is full or is it empty. Now, when the bladder is empty, it looks like there are many layers. The cuboidal cells on the basal layer, the polygonal cells above that, and those topmost cells, they look like little umbrellas. So they are umbrella-shaped cells. But when the bladder fills and it stretches, this epithelium becomes flatter. It doesn't look as stratified now. So it changes its appearance when the bladder stretches and when it contracts. This is transitional epithelium. Stratified cuboidal and stratified columnar cells, they are rare and they might line ducts. But remember the false stratification, that pseudo-stratified epithelium? All of the cells are touching the basal lamina, so it's still single-layered, but the nuclei, they are at different heights. It just looks stratified. Now, this type of epithelium is ciliated in the respiratory lining in the trachea. So the lining of the trachea, that pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. And those are some of the different types of epithelial tissue. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.